So I'm going to switch to a bicep cutter. Now when I go to my bicep cutter, I want to keep his tricep in line with my hips, kind of like an arm bar, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my leg, the one on the side that he's facing, and I'm going to throw it over his body right here, okay? And once that's over, I can let go of that wrist. Now I'm going to try on my legs, fall back. Now all I have to do is squeeze my knees, get a gable grip here. I'm pulling towards his elbow, towards the point of his elbow, making sure my knees are real tight here. And I'm going to bring my hips up just like an arm bar. Okay? With that bicep guard. Make sure his arm is bent over the bone right here. Okay? Don't have it so deep that he's on the soft muscle of your hand or your arm. And make sure he's not over the wrist. So you got cartilage in there that'll move around. You want to be right between your wrist and where your forearm is. That's that bone. That bone is thin one direction. When you rotate it, it's thick the other direction. Okay? So when we started out, we'll have it in there in the thin direction. When we start to apply pressure, I'm going to rotate it to get wide. And it's going to put a lot of pressure on that bicep, okay? So again, I spun around. I got to my Kimura. He's clasping his hands. I can't get that submission that I want. So I'm going to throw my leg over the top. I'm going to track right over his wrist, okay? I'm just going to let my butt slide right down to the mat. Triangle the legs, keep everything tight. Gable grip. I'm gonna pull my arm towards the point of his elbow and shoot my hips up. Okay? So go real slow on this one. Tap early, you're gonna have a sore bicep for about 3-4 days. If you go really hard on it, I've seen people break forearms with this or rupture biceps. Okay, so go real slow with this, tap early. But this is a good technique, especially in no-knee competition. They allow a lot more submission.